Yena shreyoham apnuyam. Arjuna continues with the same topic. He says, Vyamishra Vakyam you are using. Vyamishra Vakyam means contradictory statements, confusing statement. And what is the confusion here? You glorify Jnanam and ask me to vote for karma. Like election speech, this party is very good, therefore vote for the other party. That is called Vyamishra Vakyam. So, hey Krishna, you are supposed to be Sarvajna Ishwaraha. In the first chapter, I found I was confused. And to remove my confusion, I approached you. Instead of removing my confusion, you have added one more confusion. Minnala fight pannanama vandama angara confusion da irundhudu. Ipa karmama jnanama soli innuru confusion vandhachu. Therefore, through contradictory statements, buddhim mohayasi, you are confusing my intellect. Inge parunga, here the word buddhi should be taken as intellect. In the previous sloka, we translated buddhi as knowledge. In this sloka, we should translate buddhi as intellect. In every language, the words will have different meanings. It is true for Sanskrit also. That's why we say guru is required. Hillina and ahum, you will get all wrong meaning. But here, Arjuna uses an important expression which is to be noted. He says, you are using contradictory statements as though. That as though is very important because here Arjuna doesn't want to say that Krishna is contradicting himself because Arjuna has total faith in Krishna. How can my guru, my friend, the Lord Karunamurti confuse me? Therefore, I don't want to say you are contradicting. For me, it appears as though you are contradicting. That means what? In the previous sloka, he blamed Krishna, but by that time, Arjuna recovers himself and he puts the blame on himself. Nee tappa teach pannamata, nanda seriya purinjikale. It is my mistake. This is called vinayaha. This is called humility. This is called faith in the teacher. Guru is illogical, that means improper attitude. That is called lack of shraddha. But at the same time, we also want, it should not be blind swallowing of statements also. Because the guru has said, it appears illogical to me, but still, okay, I accept why my guru said. Therefore, if I blindly accept it also, it is not proper. If I feel there is illogicality, I should not swallow that. If I swallow that, it is called blind faith. At the same time, I should not blame the scriptures and the teacher that is illogical. Then what should I do? Instead of swallowing the seemingly illogical statements, I tell my teacher, for my understanding, it appears illogical. I know that you will not be illogical, which means I have not grasped properly. Therefore, I would request you to teach again. And I again listen, and after grasping it, I see whether there is any illogicality. Suppose again I feel illogical, ask again. And again means ask again. How many times? Until you grasp properly. And how do I know whether I have grasped properly? When I grasp properly, there will not be illogicality. There is no illogicality in our scriptures. In fact, we have got one separate text called Brahma Sutra, which is called Nyaya Prasthanam, which is exclusively meant for logical analysis of scriptures. Therefore, other people might have, other religions even might have illogicality because of their emphasis of faith. But in our scriptures, we don't emphasize faith alone, we emphasize understanding. Therefore, ask any number of questions until you are convinced. And therefore, Arjuna, instead of blaming Krishna, he shows his Shraddha and says, Krishna, you are confusing me as it were, through contradictory statements as it were and as it were. And therefore, what do I want? I won't reject you. Ekam vada nischitya. Therefore, tell me very clearly one of the sadhana. Either stress karma so that I will fight, or stress jnanam so that I will go away from here and look for knowledge. But you are stressing both of them, and that too glorifying knowledge and asking me to do karma. I don't want, tell me one. So, ekam vada nischitya, very clearly. Yena, so that by following that one path, I will either follow karma, it is blind. Swamiji, you classic class all want. You enna pannanam solunga kaalam vara endradhu adha naan panni vidren pannanama 108, because people, especially in now we would have used the intellect in our college days, adhan doubtful, because our system is memorizing system. Tappittavari college la use pannom sonna adukapram there is no scope for using at all, because most of the jobs are monotonous rote job where thinking is not required at all. One job you have to repeatedly do, and then we are so tired after office hours that we don't want to think. We only want to either read stardust, or we want to read some kind of dusty book, or we want to watch Ulim Ulim, or what is that, something like that. So, we have not used our intellect, that we don't want to think in life. This has become a big tragedy. And whenever there is a problem, they want to go to some Swami and say, Swamiji, veed adayarla vanganama, annanagarla vanganama. This is Swamiji advice. So, even for buying a house, or whether I should wear this dress or that dress, everything, you just give me a commandments, 10 commandments or 20 commandments, so that I need not think. Whereas in Vedanta, we emphasize Viveka. Shankaracharya wrote a book called Viveka Chudamanihi, because we are different from animals only because of that factor. Adhe eduthuta ennartham. We are manushya rupena mrigascharanti. So, therefore, Krishna doesn't want to advise. Therefore, our primary importance in our scriptures is advise initially, but after some time stop advising. Dayanand Swamiji says, the bane of our culture or many cultures is advice giving, value preaching. In preaching and advising, I only ask you to do a series of things, but in that you do not use your thinking capacity. What is required is teaching. And when I tell Satyam Vada, Swamiji says, Satyam Vada Chana, it is preaching. But if I tell you, what is the glory of speaking truth? what are the plus points of speaking truth, what are the minus points of speaking truth, and convert it into your value, and then I tell you, I have given you knowledge. Hereafterwards, you decide whether to speak or untruth. I don't want to decide for you. I want to only pass some knowledge. Therefore, Swamiji says, preaching is initial and superficial. Teaching alone will have long-term effort. But in army, Arjuna is used to left, right, you know. அவர் வந்து லெஃப்ட் ரைட் சொன்னால் நம்ம அவர் லெஃப்ட் சொன்னால் இடது கால வைக்கணும், ரைட் சொன்னால் ரைட் அபவுட் டேர்ன், ரைட் டேர்ன் சொன்னால் ரைட்டில் போகணும்.